Okay. So, dear children, today we want to continue with that transpose matrix. But last time, what we did, it was a square matrix. And this time, we want to transpose a matrix of any size. So, here we don't want to write this code because it is not needed. And we want to make a function in that case. So here, what is the meaning of this, children? Return type? Anybody, please tell, what is the meaning of this? It is not the temporary instance. It will, Yes, it will return a double dimensional array. And here the name of the function is get transposed mat. This is the name of the function. And it will return one matrix and will also receive one matrix, one double dimensional array. Okay. Now, one more thing, please tell me, if the size of the matrix is 4 by 3, what will be the size of the resultant matrix? 3 by 4, right. So here what to do is just declare a matrix of size 3 by 4. So here what we need to do is a 0 dot length, and here you need to write a dot length. If any doubt, then please tell. If any doubt, then please tell. It is A dot length. So A dot length means that number of rows and A0 dot length means number of columns. So here we have reversed that. So if the size of the matrix is 3 by 4, then it will be 4 by 3 here. And after we have done that transpose, return B. Any problem? In between, we have to write the code. Still, I have not written the code. I have to write the code here for the transpose. And now, what to do is you just write the traversal loop for the resultant matrix, which is B dot length for row. And for int j is equals to 0 till it is less than B0 dot length. This is for the resultant one. And here we have to write B of ij is equals to A of j of I. And the things are done. Children, we have done that. And in order to call that, what we need to do is just to create the object of the transpose matrix. And here we have filled it randomly, no issues. Here, obj dot. This is obj, okay. This is obj dot. And this is again obj dot. We need to call that function in order to get the transposed matrix, obj dot, get transposed matrix passing A. And that will return B, and here we are simply passing B in that. And here हाँ तो उसको चेंज कर देंगे बेटा. ओके. नाउ लेट अस सी दैट. Suppose the matrix is 3 by 4, and this is the matrix which is 3 rows, 4 columns. And you can see that the first row has become the first column, and the first column has become the first row. So, this is second column, second row, and it is now second column. and this is third row, and now see, you can see it is third column. So any problem in that? Now if you have any issues with this function, then please tell. What we need to do is, suppose the matrix size is 3 by 4, then we have to create a matrix of size 4 by 3 like this, where a 0 dot length will return you the number of columns and a dot length will return you the number of rows. And here the loop, both these loop will be for b, simple traversal method, that is row and call. Yes, but I am passing B na, so what? I am passing B and this is A. So what you think for this A, tell? Yes, definitely. So it will contain matrix B, but here the name of that matrix B is A. And another B local variable I have created. So both this B and this A, actually it is another B. But what is the issue? Matrix print yahan pe ho rahi hai with the help of this function. I am again calling this function na. This function will return a matrix and that will get stored in this variable B na, which is a local variable, and now I am passing. That's why the functions are needed. This is the main purpose of the function. The main purpose of the function is to provide reusability, to implement reusability in the program. That's why functions are created. Otherwise, write the simple code which we were writing earlier. Yes, if any doubt, then please tell. Lavanya Kaustubh Agarwal, Sushmita, but Lavanya, any problem? Sushmita, any issue with the code? Raghuvanshi, Mehul Singh, Mayank Singh. Ranjan Srivastav, Ayush Shukla, Ayush, any problem? Here if you see, children, the just wait, obj dot, yes, so if you see the index numbers here, suppose the first matrix is this. The first matrix is this, so the transpose will be like this. Okay. Now just focus on this code, which is this one. So what is happening? This loop will go. It is 3 and 2 because it is going for this one, 3 rows and 2 columns. And here what is happening, इनिशियली इट इज 0 0 एंड देन 1 0. सो दीज टू वैल्यूज विल गेट स्टोर्ड इन दिस मैट्रिक्स. एक्चुअली दीज टू 0 0 एंड 1 0. 0 0 एंड 1 0 विल गेट स्टोर्ड हेयर इन दिस मैट्रिक्स एंड देन दिस जे विल टर्मिनेट. आई विल बिकम वन. सो आई विल बिकम वन. दिस जे विल अगेन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 0. सो दिस टाइम 0 1 एंड 1 1 means this column will get stored here like this, and then this column will get stored like this, and finally we are returning this matrix V. So this is how we are doing the transpose. Okay, now children, remember that we have done one question earlier, and that question was to swap first row with the last, to swap the second row with the second last, right? If you remember. Okay, so please try to attempt one program in which we need to swap columns. I want only the logical part, main part. So first column you need to swap with the last column, and second column you need to swap with the second column, last second last column, like that. Hurry up fast. Hurry up fast. Start. So first column you need to swap with the last column, and post the code in the chat box or on GCR. Only the main part. And the interested student for website, please wait after the class. Yes. Why? WhatsApp me on my personal number. Yes. Okay, you send the code on GCR, no issues. Okay, it's correct. Lavanya, beta, send the code. Kushagra Garg. Harsh Chauhan. Sajal, why you are using while loop? But Sajal, always remember, when number of iterations are known, when you know that how long the loop will continue, do not use while loop. Avoid using while loop. Okay. So when number of iterations are known, don't use while loop. Don't use. Okay. So you just rewrite the code using for. हाँ हेलो, अरे आएंगे नहीं, बच्चों को मैं रोक रहा हूँ, 11th के कुछ बच्चों को बाद में, ठीक है? अरे 9:40 पे आ जाना, वो हम बच्चों को 8-10 बच्चे हैं जिनको रोक लेंगे, वो इंटरेस्टेड हैं, ठीक है? ओके, हाँ, लिंक वही है, वही वाला लिंक, हाँ निलय गुप्ता, बेटा सेंड द कोड। एनीबडी एल्स? श्रुति अग्रवाल, हाँ स्पर्श, सेंड on WhatsApp. Okay, beta sparsh, the outer loop you have used for column and the inner loop you have used for rows. Theek hai, the code is okay. But in the last, where you are swapping, you have missed one of the dimension of the matrix. So you have considered that it is a linear array only. So this is what the problem in that code. Haan Shashibita, it is okay, beta. It is okay, the code is okay. Yes, anybody else? Yes, anybody else? Ayush Shukla, beta Mehul Singh, send the code if you have written. ओके यस इट्स करेक्ट यस विद मोबाइल नंबर एंडिंग विद 639 चाइल्ड योर कोड इज नॉट करेक्ट बिकॉज यू आर एग्जीक्यूटिंग द होल पार्ट यू आर ट्रेवर्सिंग द होल मैट्रिक्स बट यू नीड नॉट टू ट्रेवर्स द होल यू नीड टू ट्रेवर्स ओनली द हाफ ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स The loop will go till R, but it will go till C by 2, where C represents the number of columns. Okay, children, here I am just going to do that this program for you. So please focus and rest of you, please verify that. So here it is. Swapping column. So why here this is the main method and this is the method for displaying the matrix. The matrix is just wait. No need to write the whole code, better to copy this. And paste this. Okay, now here what to do is, just, this is the matrix which we have declared. And Scanner class and here what we need to do is enter the matrix size so that is row and that is column And here, this matrix we have initialized. And now we need to fill that. Before that, better if you create the object of the class. So, swapping call. This is how we can create the object. And here, I'm just calling this function for printing it. And before we need to fill that matrix, so A of ij will be this random function class object and then next int and passing suppose 100 plus 10. So the values will be from 0 to 109, 1 to 109, not 1 to but 10 to 109. So the matrix is filled and will get displayed on the screen. Just see that here once. Okay, this is missing. Okay, see that? The matrix is 5 by 5, and you can see that this is the matrix. This part is being executed. What is the issue in that? Swapping, that is swapping call. Four by four. So this is the matrix. Okay, right. Now we need to swap. So here the coding for swapping. So what we need to do is just start a loop from zero till the specified number of rows, and another will go for zero till the specified number of columns. But remember, we are traversing row by row, so we need not to go for all columns. We need to go up to half number of columns, because when we will swap, suppose a matrix is of size 3 by 3, then 0 comma 0 will get swapped with 0 comma 3. So we need to come till half. And here after that 1 comma 0 will get swapped with 1 comma 3. Other elements are also, but I am just explaining randomly. So here after that, what you need to do is just you have this variable t for swapping. This is a of ij, and a of ij will be what? A of I call minus j minus 1 we have to write. Why I have written call minus j minus 1? Because if at any moment of time the value of j is 0, so then in that case call minus j minus 1 will be representing this 3. This one. Suppose j is 0, in that case call is 4, 4 minus 0 minus 1, which is 3. So if it is 0 comma 0, then here it will be 0 comma 3. So it simply means that 0 comma 0 we are swapping with 0 comma 3. Now complete this swapping procedure. So that is a of I call minus j minus 1 will be t. That is we have done. So first of all, and after swapping, we need to print the matrix again. So this is what we have done. The size of the matrix is 5 by 5, and you can see that the first column and the last column, the second column and the second last column, both all these we have swapped except the middle column, because the size is of a odd length matrix. And if yes, row minus I minus 1, why you are going to swap column na? If the matrix size is not a square matrix, then if the matrix size is suppose 3 by 4, then 3 by 4, then you will not be able to write row and use row in that case. Okay, so if you are swapping columns, better to use call then. Okay. Definitely you can write your code is correct. Your code is correct. Okay. Okay, now children. So till now, any problem in that? Okay. So I'm just giving you one more question. And this question is a little bit tricky. Consider a matrix of size, suppose 3 by 3. This is a 3 by 3 matrix. Try to find out the minimum from each and every row. That is 1 here, and that is 2 here, and that is 3 here. And maximum from each and every column, that is 3 here, that is 4 here, and that is 5 here. If you consider all these entries which you have got, will be known as one linear array with minimum from each and every row, right? And if you consider this, you can say that it is a linear array with maximum from each and every row, each and every column. So in computer science, there is a game theory in which we call such array as row minima. Row minima. And such we call these elements as column maxima. So children, if the row minima, which is a linear array which you have got, and the column maxima, which is another linear array which you have got, if the maximum from row minima, which is 3, and minimum from column maxima, which is 3, and at this point both are same, the maximum from row minima and minimum from column maxima, we can say that the saddle point exists in this matrix. Saddle point. So children, in game theory, there is a saddle point. When we process matrix data, and that is, if the maximum from row minima and minimum from column maxima is same, we can say that saddle point exists. So now, what is your task? Your task is to input a matrix of size row comma col, and you have to find out whether saddle point exists in a given matrix or not. So write a program to check if there is a saddle point in a given matrix data. And for that, what you have to do, you have to just make a Boolean function is saddle, which receives one of the matrix. Few things you have to remember: you cannot create any other linear array, you cannot create any other matrix. Using the same matrix, you have to write the code. And I have explained you how to find out the minimum from each and every row. I have also explained you how to find out maximum in each and every column in previous classes. So this question is for you. I hope you will be able to solve this question. Take the screenshot if you want. Now children, I am just providing you the Google Form link to mark your attendance. I am sending the link in your chat box, so please mark your attendance there. And after marking your attendance, you people can leave if you want. But those children will stay who are interested in website development. Yes. Beta, what's your name? Okay, I will see that. Yes, yesterday you said, na? Okay, I will see that. Okay, children, Rastogi sir has joined. Good morning, sir. Rastogi sir has joined. So we want to discuss few things. So if you have marked your attendance, those who are not interested in website development, they can leave the session. And rest of you, please stay. We want to discuss few things. Yes, sir, Rasovi sir. Hani sir, a few more if they are interested, they can stay.